I want to start off this video by giving you two examples. In example number one, just visualize a very big climax scene wherein the heroine is pushed off the cliff. She does not have a dead fall down into the valley, but while falling down, she definitely catches hold of a tree, and that's where she finds support to that fall. Okay, that is example number one for you. Example number two dates back to your childhood memories, where during your examinations, you study a lot to score good marks in your exam. After studying a lot, you score 80%. You feel motivated. Then you study harder. Even in spite of studying harder, still you get 80%. Then you study the hardest and still you get 80%. Unfortunately, you are not able to close above that resistance of 80%. These were examples of Bollywood and your routine life. But these two terms which I used, the support for that heroine and the resistance for your marks, also find a place in technical analysis. Now, what are these two terms in technical analysis? Let's check out in this video. Hi guys, C. Rachana Ranade here, and I welcome you all to my technical analysis lecture series. I'm going to quickly revise this concept that we had talked about. If you remember, we had talked about a candlestick. A red candlestick is known as a bearish candlestick. This is known as the body of the candle, and these two are known as the wick, W-I-C-K, wick, wicks of the candle. Wick is, in Marathi, we call it as vat. Okay, so that's the wick of the candle. This is also known as stick of the candle. Okay, so also known as sometimes the shadow of the candle, so many names. If this be in the green color, it is known as a bullish candlestick. Again, same thing, this is the body of the candle, this is the wick of the candle. Now, why red or why green? If the open is at this price, if the close is at this price, this is the high, this is the low, it's a red candle. Why? Because it has closed at a lower level as compared to the opening level. And if this case is with a bullish candlestick, the open is at this level, close is at this level, high and low. That was a very quick revision of my first video on technical analysis. Second video, we had talked about what are the different types of trends. Okay, so if I'm talking about a stock moves in this direction, this is known as an upper trend. Why? You find a trend going in the upward direction. This is evidenced by higher highs and higher lows. See, even lows are going in the upward direction. So all the highs goes in the higher direction, all the lows go in the lower direction. Second, we had talked about the concept of a downtrend. A downtrend would go something like this. Correct. So what is happening? That the highs are falling and simultaneously the lows are also falling. Okay. So this is a case where we are talking about a concept of downtrend. And third, if you remember, we had talked about something known as a sideways trend. So sideways trend is something like this. Stock is stuck. Wow. Stock is stuck in a specific range. So it's not able to cross a specific high. It's not able to cross a specific low. So this is known as the upward trend, the downward trend, and the sideways trend. That was about my second video on technical analysis. This was a quick revision for you. In the next section, we are going to talk about today's topic. So the example that I had taken, that the heroine was falling off the cliff. Now what happens is that, let's assume that this is the chart of some stock. Let us say I'm talking about Infosys. Okay. And if you remember, there was a bad news which came up for Infosys. And do you think that the share crashed from whatever X price to zap zero? Does this happen? Answer is no. In stock market, there'll never be a dead fall. Okay. There'll always be a scenario where the stock goes down. It finds some level, again goes up. Finds some level, again goes up. Something like that. Okay. Now, generally, if this happens, it is going up and down, and it's going up and again down. It's going again up and is coming down. I hope you can see here. I can easily draw a line here. Okay. Now, what is happening? Whenever the stock is coming down to this level, instead of dropping down here, it is being able to sustain at this level and it bounces back. Again at this level, it's not crashing below it. It's sustaining and it is bouncing back. This is nothing but that tree which I talked about. We are trying to have a support there. So similarly, this will be known as a price support level. So generally, the stock will not crash below this level. Okay. I hope you have understood this. In a similar scenario, instead of a support, if I try to draw another graph, let us say again 0 to X price, whatever is the price, you see a stock going up, it comes down, it again goes up, it comes down, it again goes up, it comes down, and again goes up, and so on and so forth. Now, what is happening? It's clearly a very easy visual effect is that the stock is going down, is trying to come up, it's not able to cross here. the moment the stock price is reaching here, the bears, which is like the sellers, are forcing it to push down. Okay, here again the bulls take charge, the buyers take charge, they take the price to a higher level, but here against the sellers, the bears are taking the position and they're pushing the stock price downwards. So what is happening essentially is that the stock is not able to cross a specific level. The example that I gave you was of that 80%. So this level is known as a resistance level. Okay. Now, it's very easy to draw it, but does this really happen in actual live charts is what we are going to see right away. I'm going to show you a live chart. I took a trade today based on support and resistance level, also based on certain price patterns. Price patterns is not what we are going to discuss today, but I'm going to show you actual example of a support level, resistance level in one stock, and then I can tell you how to trade in that using a trading strategy. Like in the iPad version, which I showed you right now, it was very simple. Like I just drew it like this, that I showed you. This is the stock movement, and here you can just draw this line. This is the resistance or this is the support. I just do it like that, okay? I know it has not touched properly, but it's okay. I'm going to show you today, right now, as to how you can use some free softwares and you can easily draw a support line, trend line by yourself. There are two rules which you have to remember while drawing these lines. Rule number one, try to touch maximum number of candles, number one, okay? Maximum points you have to touch. And number two, you can cut through a wick, but you're not allowed to cut through a candle. Okay, keep these two things in mind. Number one, try to join maximum dots. Number two, you're allowed to cut through a wick, you're not allowed to cut through the body of the candle. Okay, I'm going to show you a chart, which is okay. This in.tradingview.com. I've opened the chart of DMART right now. So if you go to the full featured chart, that's how it loads. So here we are on in.tradingview. Now, what is to be done is we are going to draw a resistance level first. Okay, so that's how it's very easy. I'm just choosing this, and let's say I want to draw let's say a horizontal line. Okay, so what was our thumb rule? You have to try to touch maximum number of, let's take a trend line, try to touch the maximum number of candles. Okay, and here we are. Okay, so assume that we are on this day. We are at this level right now. Okay, now what happens? Okay, we are at this day. These were the two lines that we were able to touch. And here you can see a big green candle. I know it's at the fag end of the chart, but try to concentrate. This is a green candle which has come up. This is the bullish candle or the bearish candle? Yes, it's the bullish candle and with a very big body of the candle. So it's a very positive sign. What has happened? Has it also cut the trend line? Yes, where has it closed? It has closed above the which level? Support level or resistance level? This was the resistance level. See, the stock tried to go up here. It did not. Immediate day, second day, it tried to go up. It did not. Here also, you can see in the previous almost a month ago, it tried to go above this. It did not. So, two, three back-to-back attempts, but it had failed to go above that. So, that's a resistance. Now, on this particular day, this is what? 20th of September 2019, barely 3 months ago, it was able to cross this level. Which level? Resistance level. And now, see what happens? Up, 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 up. It has gone up. Now what has happened? Let us understand. Now here you can see that there are big reds which have formed now. Okay. Now let us try to first extend this line till this level. Okay. Now what has happened? Here you can see that the stock is nearing this support. Number one, if you are drawing just a horizontal line, but please understand that it's not necessary that support or resistance have to be in a horizontal direction. It could also be in a slanting direction. So I'll try to draw one more trend line for you. Just see, I'm trying to draw these. I'm trying to use the maximum number of candles. Okay, wait. I'll just draw one more line. Right. So this was the line which I drew yesterday. So yes, I was talking about this. I just lost on the arrow part. So this is 11th of December is what we are talking about today. And yesterday I just was studying this chart, DMART. And here you can clearly see that support number 1, 2, 3, support number 4. And here the candle was broken. So this is where I saw yesterday. Now you'll say that, ma'am, you only told you are not allowed to cut through the body of candle. So this candle was the first time that it cut this support line. Now, can I say the support has been broken? Multiple supports it had taken and it has broken this. So now what will happen? This ought to go down. And today only I took a trade on this. and I have gained whatever. I'll show you if you want. If you want proof, I can show that also. But see, this support has been broken. Okay, there's one more pattern which is very clearly evident. Those who know technical analysis, this is known as the head and shoulder pattern. Just try to imagine this. Shoulder, head, shoulder. But instead of a horizontal, try to imagine something like this. Okay, some diagonal or something like that. So here you can see this is like a shoulder. It's like a head and another shoulder. And this is broken now. Now when this is broken, it has to go in the bearish trend. It has to go down. And this is where I had done a short sale. Today morning, I sold few shares of DMart. And I did calculate a small target price. I achieved that. I quit the position in barely 1.5-2 hours. And I gained 1,000 rupees out of that. If you want, I'll show you the trade also, how it happened. Okay, but that's how we can trade. If you want to know more about technical analysis, I'm going to take a live batch in Pune, which starts on 16th of, which has now, because this will release after a few days, 4-5 days at least. So this has recently started 16th of December in Pune. It's at Expert Professional Academy. If you want to know the details, the number is 2445-0001. And don't worry, if you're outside Pune, this entire recording of this live batch, it'll be available for you all from the first week of January. Hope you have enjoyed this. I forgot to show you the trade. I'll show that right away. Okay, so generally, I don't do a lot of intraday trades. So if you check out my ratio, maybe out of 10, I would do 8 delivery-based tradings and maybe just 1 or 2 intraday trades. So I do it comparatively less often as compared to my delivery-based trades. But today, I'm going to give you an example of how I did an intraday trade for DMart. Here you can see, I had sold DMart and this order, you can see here, I did this, I sold DMart 50 quantity at 10:44. Okay, so morning, 10:45, pone 11 baje, I sold 50 quantity. This was a short sale. I don't have DMart in my account right now. I did a short sale. Now these two orders at 1710 and 1702, these were not market orders. If you see, these were limit orders. So I'd originally put this into my system that whenever stock goes down to 1710, buy half quantity, so square of half quantity. And when it goes down to 1702, buy the pending quantity, square of the pending quantity. Okay, so this trade got triggered at 11:45. This trade got triggered at 12:30. Here you can also see that there is a stop loss order. And this stop loss order I had put at 1732. Now, what was this? I sold it at 1726. Had it climbed up, then I said that at 1733, book my losses. Okay, so here it is. So I just went to reports and then into my net position. Here you can see, this is the DMart thing. I sold at 1726. I purchased it back at 1706, which is the average price. So got a difference of 20 rupees and whatever. This is the last traded price. And this is the realized profit, 1,000 rupees profit in one day. Even if anyone is earning more than that in a single day, but this 1,000 rupees profit done with proper studies is what gives you a lot of pleasure. I hope you have understood this. Today we talked about support, we talked about resistance, we talked about using a basic strategy for support and resistance. Please be sure, don't buy or don't sell just because it has crossed or it has breached the support or resistance level. You need to check a lot more parameters and then take an informed decision to take a trade. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. That's it from my side. I hope you have enjoyed this. Consider subscribing to my channel. Consider sharing this video with your friends. That's it. And whatever you can find, whatever all the links are always there in the description box. Just try to check it out. Okay, so that's it. Jai Hind. Bye-bye.